High Rock Spring. Our theme this year is called For Such a Time as This. And this phrase comes straight out of the Bible from the book of Esther, which is the story of a young girl who saves her people. It's really a great story. It's got kings and queens and palace intrigue and all sorts of interesting things happen. And the heroine is a very unlikely girl. Could have been anybody. It could be one of us. How are we called to be in such a time as this? I thought it would be interesting for you to hear kind of the whole story, because we're going to read it in different parts over a bunch of different Sundays, and it can sometimes be hard to track. So I thought today I would read to you from this book called Read, Wonder, Listen, which is a story book, a story Bible for children by Laura Alary. Here is the picture of Queen Esther. Let's listen to the story. Sometimes God works through the people we least expect, like a young Jewish woman who found herself in the royal court of Persia. It all began when King Ahasuerus hosted a great feast and ordered his wife, Queen Vashti, to come and dance for his guests. Queen Vashti said, "No, I am no dancing girl," she declared. "I am the queen of Persia." But she wasn't queen for long. The king was furious at not getting his own way, so he took away Vashti's royal crown and began to look for a new wife. All across the empire, his servants searched for beautiful and accomplished young women and brought them to the palace. One of the women they brought was Esther. "If the king chooses you," warned her uncle Mordecai, "do not tell anyone you are a Jew. Some Persians hate our people." Sure enough, the king was charmed by Esther and made her the new queen. As Mordecai had urged, Esther told no one who she really was, but in secret she prayed every day to the God of Israel. Now King Ahasuerus had an advisor called Haman, a proud and vain man who loved to ride through the city streets just so people would bow down to him. But Mordecai refused to bow. "Do you know who I am?" demanded Haman. "You should bow down to me." "I am a Jew," replied Mordecai, "and I bow down only to my God." "We'll see about that," muttered Haman. A terrible idea crept into Haman's mind, the perfect way to punish Mordecai. Haman went to the king and told a lie. "Your Majesty," he said, "it grieves me to tell you that there is a danger lurking in your empire. People called the Jews refuse to obey your laws. If you don't get rid of them, they will destroy you." The king was afraid, so he issued a royal decree that all Jews in the empire must be killed. When Mordecai heard this news, he went to see Esther in the palace. "It is time to speak out," he insisted. "Tell the king your secret." "What good would that do?" wondered Esther. "You are the queen of Persia," cried Mordecai. "Maybe God brought you to this very place and time so you could save your people." That night, Esther sat in her garden, still and quiet under the night sky. "Creator of the stars," she prayed, "you are in every place and every time. Be with me now. Work through me to bring good out of this great evil." By morning, Esther felt ready. She dressed in her best clothes and went to see the king, even though no one, not even the queen, was allowed to approach him without an invitation. But King Ahasuerus was not angry, especially when Esther invited him to dinner the following night. As tea was being served at dinner, Esther spoke out. "Your Majesty," she said, "there is a reason I invited you here tonight. Someone close to you is trying to kill me." "Who would dare?" roared the king. "The one who sits at the table with you now," said Esther. "It was Haman who turned you against the Jews." "Well, I am a Jew. These are my people. Their suffering is my suffering. Even King Ahasuerus could not take back a royal decree, but he gave the Jews permission to fight back against anyone who tried to harm them. He got rid of Haman once and for all and made Mordecai his new chief advisor. As for Queen Esther, she was admired and honored by Persians for her wisdom and beauty. But among the Jews, she was deeply loved for her courage and compassion, and was always known as the one who saved her people. So all through this year, we will be thinking about what are the special gifts we have, and what have we been put in this time and place to do?